Hello and welcome to WPKlik's YouTube channel. Today we're going to talk about how you can edit the images on your WordPress website in no time and without any particular effort, so stay tuned. The media library is where you can add and manage all your media. You can reach it by going to Media and then clicking on Library in your WordPress dashboard. Once you're there, just click on the media item you want to edit. After selecting the item that needs editing, you will see an Edit More Details option on the right side of the screen. Click on it to reach the Edit Media page. To make sure you get all the options shown on the screen, you need to open the Screen Options at the top of the screen and mark all the available fields. There are several settings you can customize in the Edit Media screen, and we'll go through all of them. Title is where you insert the name of your media item. The title is usually displayed in the file section of the media library and can also be shown on attachment pages and galleries. Permalink is the URL you can use to link to this media item. There may also be a button here that lets you edit the permalink. If not, you can mark the slug checkbox in Screen Options and change the link in the slug field. As for Edit Image, clicking on this button allows you to make additional images to your image. We'll talk about this option in more detail later. Caption is a field you can use to add a caption or a description to your media item. The Alternate Text option is used for ease of access. It's where you can assign an alternative label to your media item, and it's also important for SEO. Under Description, you get to further describe your media. There is also a Save Meta box on the right side of the screen that displays all the media information, such as the upload date, file URL, file name, size, type, and dimensions. It also allows you to choose whether you want to delete your file permanently or update your changes. The additional media options only become visible if you previously enabled them in the Screen Options tab. These options include Discussion, Comments, Slug, and Author. Discussion lets you enable or disable the ability to leave comments, while the Comments option shows a list of recent comments for the media file in question. We already mentioned the Slug option earlier. You can use it to edit the permalink. And last but not least, with the Author option, you can choose the author of your media. Clicking on the Edit Media button located right below the image opens a set of several image editing controls. Here, in addition to adding the usual data such as title, caption, alt text, and description, you also have basic editing options at your disposal. These include rotating, scaling, and cropping. Use the Scale Image option to scale the original image proportionally. In order to get the best results, you should scale your image before you do any cropping, flipping, or rotation. You should also know that you can only scale down the images, not up. Once you're done, hit the Scale button and your newly scaled image will be displayed instead of the original. Also, if you decide to restore the image to its original size, the Restore Original Image button that appears after an image has been scaled will let you do this. To crop the image, you need to click and drag the image to select the part that you wish to crop. When you're done, click the crop icon in the top left corner above the image to save your selection. As for the image crop, when combined with the crop icon, this option lets you make more accurate changes to your image. The aspect ratio lets you specify the aspect ratio of your crop selection if you hold down the Shift key while dragging. There are also selection fields inside which you can change the values in pixels if you've already started your cropping. These values are scaled to roughly match the dimensions of the original. Aside from these options, you can also rotate your image clockwise, counterclockwise, flip it vertically or horizontally, and use undo redo buttons to remove or return to the previous edit. Of course, there are also save and cancel options that are pretty self-explanatory. And that's all there is to editing your images in WordPress. We hope you found this tutorial helpful. For more information on this topic, check out the description and make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel.